I've set up two tables in this database, a students table with detailed information about each student, like their name and email, and a student grades table, which has their student ID, test name, and grade. Let's see what happens if we just select everything from student grades. Ta-da! Okay, so we see student IDs, test names, and grades. I'd actually rather be able to see student names, emails, that sort of thing. Now, what you might notice is that the student ID in student grades is related to the ID in students. So this one here is actually referring to Peter Rabbit, and this two here is actually referring to Alice in Wonderland. Now, I want to form a query that will output the student name and email next to each test grade. And that information is in two different tables. So that means I need to join the tables. And there are a few ways that we can do that in SQL. And we'll try them all out, actually. The simplest is called a cross join. And I can make that happen just by putting both table names after the from. Ta-ta! So as you can see, lots of rows. And basically, what this did is that for each row in the first table, it created a row for each of these rows here. That means we end up with 8 rows because it creates 4 rows for each of these 2 rows. This is the simplest join, but it's also the least useful. We don't want every row matched with every other row. We only want them matched if the student ID matches. Now we can do that using an inner join, which isn't actually much more work at all and is way more useful. So there's actually a few ways of doing an inner join. We'll start with just building off the last query, and we can add a where. And the where will check to see that the student ID matches students.id. All right, so now we actually have what we wanted, is test grades next to names. Because it's done the cross join and then just limited to the rows where those columns were the same. Great. This syntax here is called an implicit inner join, and it works, but it's not actually the best practice. The better way is if we do something called an explicit inner join. And that is using the join keyword. So to do that, we're going to start with just doing from one table. And actually, I'll do from students and then join on student grades. And then instead of where, we do on. And that specifies what columns are being matched. So on students.id equals students grade dot student ID. All right, so now we have the same results as before. Switched, but really the same. Now that I have these tables joined, I'm just gonna whittle down the columns I'm outputting to the names, the email, the test name, and the grade. Okay, beautiful. Now the cool thing is, once we've done joins, we can still use where and group by and all those fancy things. Like, let's say that we want to filter down the results to just grades greater than 90. Woohoo! Let's see. Oh, no. Great. There we go. Haha. Lots of ones above 90. Now I can email all those students with a high five. Okay, but what would happen if my tables both contain columns with the same column name but different meanings? Like right now, our student grades table has a grade column. Well, what if my students table also had a grade column for their overall class grade? That would mean down here, when we selected grade, it wouldn't know which table to pull it from because there'd be a grade column in both of our tables. So actually, to be super safe, we should prefix our columns with the table name that they're from. So we say students.firstname, students.lastname, students.email, student grades.test, student_grades.grade. Okay, now we know that we're going to get the columns from the table we expect them to be in. Great. Now that is our basic explicit inner join, and it is what you'll use for most of your joins across related tables. But if you stay tuned, I'll show you a few other types of joins as well.